Senator Braun tried to pull the fast one, and you know what? The MSNBC host did not allow him to get away with it. And this is what the kind of stuff that we're supposed to do. Not allow these clowns to get away with the lies. But you know, I mean, he's kept on talking, and yes, some would say he got across, but she kept on reminding him that you're paying for past expenses. Check this out, and then we'll go ahead and take it on the other side.
Big difference. This is something that we've never done before, and it's being sold that we're going to pay for a good portion of it. And a lot of the tax proposals, even most of the Democrats, or many of them, wouldn't be for when it gets beyond two or three proposals. So I'm thinking
that... Let's be super clear, though, Senator. If you, like, raising the debt ceiling, right, is about not defaulting on the money already spent that was spent under somebody who you... you know, supported, one of your party's former leaders, Donald Trump, right? That was money. That was, those are bills that President Trump and that Congress racked up that you now have to pay. How are you not going to do that?
That's part of those trillion-dollar deficits that we had evolved to even then. And I wasn't for that. I didn't vote to raise the debt ceiling when I was here in 19. One of the few Republicans that'll practice what we preach. If you don't have reforms, don't accommodate it. So the difference here is that never have we teed up this amount of spending. And in the context, Hallie, $18 trillion in debt when I got here, in January of 19, now 28.4. This is kicking something down the road, and there's a point. Yes, it's like we've had an epiphany as Republicans. We better practice what we preach when we do get the reins back of lowering deficits and still being engaged in issues like reforming health care, being involved in a climate discussion with conservative ideas. We don't do that. So we got to do better when we do get it back, but we've never seen anything like this where not one Republican voted for the spending that we now want to raise the debt ceiling to accommodate as well.
I just have to be super clear again. You know, the discussion that is happening right now that we talked about just a moment ago, that President Biden's talking about, is disconnect. Like, the debt ceiling, getting that raised, is money that's already spent. What I hear from you, Senator, and correct me if I'm wrong, I hear you acknowledging, in some ways, the hypocrisy of your own party when you talk about how it is, to use a paraphrase from you, convenient now that Republicans are going to go against this. Is that fair?
No, I'm saying that if there aren't any reform measures associated with anything we do here, I'm not going to be for it. I've been clear that this has evolved over a couple decades of where we've been borrowing to do the things that we consume. Coming out of World War II, debt exceeded at any time in our country's history percentage of GDP. We were savers and investors. We paid it off, built the interstate highway system. We're consumers and spenders now, and that's been both parties. So you got to draw a line in the sand that $6.5 trillion total between rescue and this is spending in a binge that we've never seen before, and we both have guilt on how we got here pre-2021. I can't have my fingerprint on it, so.
I don't want to belabor the point again. Of course, some of that spending was done prior, right, to this current administration, and some was in response to this pandemic. Just as a businessman, Senator, you and I have talked about this. You're a business guy, right? Do you worry about what would happen if, in fact, we do go over that cliff, right? The effect that a default would have on the economy and the responsibility that your party would have for some of that.
So, again, this is accommodating future, this spending that's teed up currently as well. And yes, most of that blame would be on the fact we've evolved over many years to get
as
where we are.
As you pointed out, yes.
And sooner or later, we're going to have to reconcile it with all of our concerns and needs that we want as each party, but not borrow it from our kids and grandkids. Okay. And I know all Americans agree with that.
It's hard to fathom this guy. Let's first get a few facts. The economy has always done better under Democratic rule than under Republican rule. That is something that is verifiable. You can look at the stats. It's all there for all to see. Don't take my word for it. Número dos. Democrats in general are fiscally more responsible. They have smaller debt deficits than do Republicans. Verifiable. Look it up. And likewise, Democrats attempt to pay for their bills more so than Republicans. Good example, Build Back Better the portion, the human portion. The real fight is about how are we going to pay for it. They were talking about paying for it. The bipartisan thing, they weren't all that interested in paying for it. And likewise, the big Trump tax cut, not paid for. We have to tell the truth and stop allowing these guys to spin. I like what she said, which was important. Are you acknowledging the hypocrisy of your party? He didn't admit to it, but in effect, that's exactly what it is. We spend a lot of time deconstructing the news, trying to parse it into a form that everybody can understand. We try to find those little nitpicks where it flies above the fray, etc. If you really like these videos that we do, I want to ask a big favor. Please go ahead, number one, subscribe to our channel, and number two, please join if you can. Thank you so kindly for watching. Keep watching. Please remember to share. We must populate the entire internet with our progressive message, a message that we know is what most Americans say that they want. So help us, please, join.